Hey Rebels, welcome back to another video. And starting off, I will be taking the Morphe 35A palette, and I'm going to take this color. It's like a burnt plum. The colors in this palette don't have names, so I kind of have to describe them. So I'm going to take this color. It's like a burnt plum color, and I'm going to use that as my transitioning color. I'm applying it right above my crease using the Morphe brush M532. Next, going back into the Morphe 358 palette, I'm going to pick up this bright purple. It's like a Barney purple, and I'm going to use that color and apply it to my crease and blend it in with my transitioning color as well using the Morphe M330. Next, I'll be going in with my Fenty Beauty Concealer in the color 350, and I'm going to go ahead and carve out my cut crease. I'm not dragging it all the way to the end of my eyelid, just like midway through. We're going to do like a semi-halfway cut crease kind of thing today, you know. Next, I'm going to go in with the Anastasia Beverly Hills Glitter, which is called Blazing Sunset. And to apply this glitter, I'm going to take the Duo Adhesive Eyelash Glue, and I'm going to apply a tad bit onto my eyelid at a time, and then apply the glitter on top of it so we can get like a nice even coat. I didn't show the Duo Eyelash Glue because I forgot to, but if you're really into makeup, you know what Duo Eyelash Glue look like. So yeah. I'm just simply taking one brush and applying the glue, and then I'm taking another brush and dipping it into the glitter and applying it to the glue. So it did take me a little while to do this because I wanted to make sure it was like a nice, thin, even coat. I didn't want it to be like too heavy on my eyelid because I knew I was going to be putting on glitter and applying eyelashes as well. So you gotta be patient when it comes to this step because it can be tedious, but if you do it right and you take your time, it's gonna be cute, it's gonna be shit popping. Period. And what's funny about this look is that like while I was in the process of doing it, I wasn't sure if I wanted to apply this color glitter because I felt like my eyeshadow was already purple and pink, and then like the glitter was pink, and I was like, is that too much pink? And then I was like, girl, who cares? Like the heck? Next, I'm going to take the MAC Black Track Fluid Liner, and I'm going to go ahead and do a cat eye. Just to wipe off any excess glitter that might have fell from me applying the glitter to my eyelid, I'm going to take a makeup wipe and just wipe my face down and preparing it for my foundation. Next, I'll apply my eyelashes, which is these mink eyelashes that I got from the beauty supply store. I applied them off camera because you guys see me apply eyelashes like a million and one times. And next, I'm going to take my Laura Mercier foundation primer, and I'm going to go ahead and apply that to my face. And for today's foundation, I am using the Fenty Beauty foundation in the shade 345, which is my wintertime color. To apply my foundation, I am using the M406 brush by Morphe. If you guys don't know, it is a stippling brush. Lately, I've really been into like stippling brushes. I don't know why, but I feel like they just apply foundation so like nice and fluid. I I just personally feel like they leave like a nice flawless touch to your foundation. So yeah. Going back into my Fenty concealer in the shade 350, I'm going to go ahead and highlight my face, which is under my eyes, down the bridge of my nose, my forehead, and my chin. And I'm just going to blend it out using a dome blending brush. So I know in my review I said that the Fenty concealer actually really dries fast, but I don't know, when I used it again in this video, it didn't do what I thought it was going to do. Like, it didn't dry fast. Or maybe, I don't know, maybe it's different because I did use a brush this time instead of using a sponge. But I felt like it did blend out a little bit better. So I think with this kind of concealer, you just have to use a brush instead of a sponge, because the sponge just didn't get the job done the way I wanted it to. So yeah, if I would have to suggest anything, I would just say for this concealer, make sure you use a brush. Also, to get closer, I don't know what I was doing, what I was saying, but anyway, to get closer into my eyes and under my eyes, I'm going to go ahead and take a smaller blending brush and blend out my concealer, because I don't know, I need to find a dome blending brush that's smaller, because this brush that I'm using right now, a smaller one, is not really a dome blending brush. I just picked a random brush, but I need to keep my eye open for a smaller dome blending brush for my under eye concealer. So to set my under eye concealer and my foundation, I'm using the Fenty Beauty powder in the color Banana. My camera had cut off when I was applying the powder, but I did turn it back on by the time I was done applying. I don't know how it cut off. It just stopped. I don't know. And I realized, I was looking at my viewfinder and I realized it stopped. And I was like, wait, hold up, pause, rewind. So yeah, but y'all seen me apply powder like a million times before, so it ain't nothing new. So girl, today we are going to cream contour. I feel like I ain't cream contouring like forever. So I'm taking the Anastasia cream contour kit, and I'm going to take the color, I think it's called chocolate. And I'm only going to contour my cheekbones. And I'm going to blend it out using a Kashuk sponge. I don't know if I'm saying it right. It looks like it's supposed to be pronounced Kashuk. I don't know. But it's one of them new sponges that just came out, the marble black and white sponge. So yeah, you can get it from Target. So to set my cream contour, I'm going to be taking the Anastasia Beverly Hills Powder Contour Kit. And I'm going to set my cream contour. And I'm also going to contour around my forehead, down my nose, and my jawline. The brush that I'm using to contour my face is the Morphe M530 Contour Brush. And I love this contour brush. Like, this contour brush is popping. And I told y'all in my last video that I was going to get all new brushes because I felt like I'm too talented to not have good quality brushes. So I went and I got me some new brushes from Ulta. I got like 10 Morphe brushes and they came up to like $80. And I was like, why so much? But I got me some new Morphe brushes and I really like them. Now it's time for my favorite part, because you already know I'm about to be shining bright like a diamond. I'm going to take the Anastasia Glow Kit, and I'm taking the color Sunray, and I'm just going to highlight my face. I'm highlighting the apples on my cheeks and my eyebrow bones, as usual. Nothing new. Oh, and the tip of my nose, the bridge of my nose, and my chin, and a little bit on my forehead. I don't like to put too much on my forehead, because I don't know, I kind of feel like I got a big forehead, so I don't really want to draw too much attention, so. To set my face, I'm using the MAC Prep and Prime Setting Powder. I said setting powder. The MAC Prep and Prime Setting Spray, and I'm going to spray that all over my face. And once I'm done doing that, I'm going to take my Chinese fan and fan my face dry. And for today's lipstick, I'm going to take this pink lipstick in the color, what is this called? Craft. Yeah, it's called Craft, and I'm going to apply that to my lip. I was going to apply the color Naked, which is a new color, to the middle. But then after I put on this pink color, I was like, I really don't need to add another color. So I just left it the way it was. So I never wound up using a new color because I felt like I didn't need to. So yeah, that is the finished look. Thank you for watching. Thank you for staying tuned. Make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, Rebels.